Check the rock. You know, it's JP's party. There's gonna be hot music. You know what I mean? There's gonna be dancing, and you're gonna be dancing to the best.
If you can remember the music, it's not a good party, huh?
I don't remember hearing the music so much as feeling it, as like a pulsing rhythm, impressive bodies, clothes wisping across my face. I remember flannel.
I actually was not at the party.
Now, what is music even? It's just people having, every song is about some dude getting his heart broke or some chick driving a car. And, there was some man with WK, and that was good.
Margaritas aren't such a nice touch. I mean, it really brought up the level of class of the party.
I found them to be decadent, unnecessary, gauche. And a catalyst for immorality, frankly.
I thought
they looked good.
Well, they kind of sucked because when I got there, they weren't even like running right, and it was kind of all watery and sloshy. But wasn't there a keg? The keg was nice.
I actually don't drink, but everybody I saw around me had this huge smile on their face, and they seemed really sloppy. So I liked it from afar.
Really good, really tasty, icy cold, very sweet, but not too sweet, just a perfect amount of sweetness. It's nice to drink something cold, because you're dancing, you're hot, you want a warm beer, nah, you want something icy in your throat.
What was your margarita of choice?
Lemon lime.
Again, I was not at the party, I don't know.
Where were you when you first started?
Mango.
Mango. I like rainbow.
Rainbow?
Yeah,
I think we're gonna have rainbow this year.
Where were you?
I went with the standard. There was the fruity one that was fine. I gave that a shot. I think I may have only given that a shot once the other one was gone, but I'm all straight margarita. Right. Did you guys have salt?
Last year, they had the machines, right? It was last year the margarita machines. Yeah, that was interesting. That was fun. I had never seen a margarita machine before.
I was dancing on the dance floor, and someone pointed out to me that the people from the margarita machine place were sleeping in the second row, waiting to take those home.
They were glad to be there. They were happy campers.
Yeah. I was having a good time on the dance floor, and then I noticed that the mustachioed, sort of Sipowitz-y looking guy was just snoringly asleep in the second row, waiting for it to end so he could take his margarita machines home. I like that a lot.
After it was over, there was some leftover tequila that I got to take. Sweet.
I was making out with a girl by the chill out room, and it was really dirty. Literally, like it's a really dirty hallway.
My favorite memory from the party is right at the end when I saw a young lady. She must have been like 21 or so. Like I guess it was her 21st birthday. Why else would she be that drunk?
It's foggy for about 2 or 3 hours, but I always remember leaving when the sun is coming up. And I feel mad.
And I saw her throw up and then pass out right in her throw up. And I walked over to her and I put this little bracelet on her forehead.
And it wasn't there like a tortilla flavored liquor?
Maybe that's something party I'm thinking of.
I think with most like UCB parties, they sort of run together like in for me, it's like just like brooding.
I think my most vivid memory was actually when I got home, because I was extremely drunk, and I remember having blood on my legs, not knowing how it got there.
Brooding in the corner.
But that's just status quo for me. That's like a successful night, I feel like. It's like I still go, because it's like, that was fun.
My most vivid memory, honestly, was meeting Justin.
My girlfriend, I think I was smelling dude. He was black, but he was from France, and he had an accent. The two things that drive her wild are fucking
are black men and accents.
Cold margaritas, good times, good tunes, good fun.
Just a small town girl, living in a lonely world. She took the midnight train going.